Well, as soon as lockdown was announced across some areas of the country, we saw people beelining to the bottle-o to stock up. Unsurprisingly, experts say that we see a rise of alcohol consumption during a crisis. But would you ever consider using this time to take a break from the booze?
Yeah, our next guest is on a mission to challenge Aussies' attitudes towards not drinking, especially during a pandemic. Queensland mother, entrepreneur and founder of alcohol-free education platform Tapped In, Sarah Connolly. She joins us now just in time for dry July.
Sarah, it's great to see you this morning. Thank you so much. We are seeing a pretty consistent decline, this surprised me actually, in Aussies' alcohol consumption. You're 18 months sober. Congratulations. But you say that choosing to go alcohol-free wasn't actually the hard part. What do you mean by that?
Well, for me, it was certainly not as challenging as for some. So I wasn't in serious addiction. I was what you call a grey area drinker. Mm-hmm. And so the choice to give up drinking was available to me. I could make that decision. But the really hard part was, how was I going to function in the world as a non-drinker? And I was terrified about how that would play out.
Sarah, your drinking habits, they started to escalate after you lost your father, Gordon, to cancer. Sorry about that. Could you tell us about this period of your life? I mean, how much were you drinking a day?
So my dad got a six-month prognosis, and in 3 months I travelled back to the UK 3 times. So if you've done that trip, you know it's quite gruelling. Then I had a lot of, obviously, grief. I had no accountability, I had no routine, and the drinking just got, for me, out of control. But I think the interesting question that people always ask is, how much were you drinking? And I used to ask people that question myself because I wanted to compare what I was drinking.
What's
and I'm
normal?
Not sure if it's a really helpful question, because for me, I think it's about how much are you drinking for you. Is it too much? And we're all individual and we all need to ask ourselves that question. So if I tell you I was drinking a bottle of wine a night, you probably find that there are so many people that relate to that but don't think that it's necessarily an issue. So I think it's just how much is too much for you?
Yeah, and it becomes an issue when it impacts on your life, regardless of how much you drink. Now, you actually completed a rehab course to remove alcohol from your life completely. What did you learn?
Oh, it's a great question. Well, when I went in, I still wanted to drink, but I didn't want the consequences. And when I went into rehab, what I wanted to do was find a way of wanting not to drink because I wanted the consequences of being a non-drinker. So the first thing I learned when I went in was just how bad it could get. And I think that was a real motivator because I could see what was possible. Some people really are struggling with addiction and it's horrific. So that was part of it. And then I spent a lot of time looking at actually what do I want instead and really focusing on the things that I wanted out of my life that alcohol was getting in the way of. So I really kind of flipped it on its head and I really wanted to find out how can my life be so much better without it as opposed to spending a life thinking I wish I could drink but I can't. It's a very different way of looking at it.
Yeah, you also, I can relate to this, you also revealed that you were met with a lot of cynicism after you became sober. Can you tell us how people and restaurants, I guess, responded to your alcohol-free lifestyle?
Yeah, look, I don't think it was the alcohol-free lifestyle part. It was more that I was so happy to not be drinking that people really struggled with. I think people were expecting me to be kind of excluded and down and depressed about it. And I was so happy to be free from alcohol. So the response was challenging in that regard because people didn't understand. And then in the restaurant trade, not drinking equals not making money in a lot of people's minds. Mm. So as a non-drinker, we really struggle to get great alternatives because they think the demand isn't there, but it absolutely is. There are so many people now who they still drink, but they just want to drink less. So I'm really trying to advocate to have more alcohol-free options in venues so that people can make better choices if they want to.
We love how you've turned your life around, Sarah. You can follow Sarah's alcohol-free education and community platform by heading over to tappedin.com.au. Sarah, it's so good to see you looking happy and well.
Thank you so much for having me.